My name is Nagendra Prasad, TGT English, working with TTW URJC, Tirumalayapalam, Khammam district. How are you, students? I hope both we are sailing on the same boat. Today, let us together learn the important topic, the sentence. The sentence. A sentence is a group of words which makes a complete sentence. Students, I repeat, a sentence is a group of words which makes a complete sense. Here, I repeat a phrase, group of words. Let me give an example. Gentleman, he is a. It is also a group of words, but it doesn't give complete sense. Now check another sentence which is derived from the above sentence. I arranged the words in this sentence in a meaningful order. He, I take next verb is, article A, gentleman, noun. He is a gentleman. It gives complete sense or meaning. So this is called a sentence. Let us have a glance again the definition. A sentence is a group of words which makes a complete sense. Here the first example gives complete sense. He is a gentleman. Let us check another example. Shut the door. How lovely it is. Where do you live? Dear children, is there any difference among these four sentences? Yes, absolutely. The first two sentences ends with full stop. The third sentence ends with the exclamatory mark. The last sentence ends with question mark. So, we have four kinds of sentences. Let us discuss kinds of sentences later. Now, let us look here. Every sentence has two parts. The first one is the subject. Let us go through the subject. Subject is the part which names the person or thing we are speaking about. I repeat, subject is the part which names the person or thing we are speaking about. Children. Now, I'm talking about a cat. Then cat is the subject. If you want to talk about your mother is the subject. If we together talk about a chair, chair is the subject. I think you understand what do you mean by subject. Here I give a beautiful example. My father is a teacher. In this sentence, the first phrase, which is in red color, my father is subject. Here I wanted to talk about my father. So my father is subject. Good. Next. The second part of the sentence is the predicate. Predicate is the part which tells something about the subject. I repeat. Predicate is the part which tells something about the subject. we have already discussed about subject. Now, let us discuss the predicate with an example. My father is a teacher. Students, just forget about my father. Let you focus on this next part, which is in red color. Is a teacher. Who is teacher? My question is, who is teacher? Just the answer is my father. Okay, that's good. This part tells is a teacher. This part tells about this part. This part is called subject part. So the part which talks, which tells about the subject, that is called predicate. I think you understand. This part tells, the part which tells, the part which in the sentence tells about the subject, that part is called predicate. Good. I think you understand what you mean by predicate. Next. I have already informed you. We find there are differences among the sentences. In the above examples, in the first slide, we noticed that the first two sentences end with a full stop. The third sentence ends with an exclamatory mark. The last one ends with, yes, you're right, question mark. With the examples, we understood sentences are varied. Then how many sentences are there in English language? Not only in English language, but also in all languages, there are only four kinds of sentences. Sentences are of four types. The first one, statement sentence. Children, the sentence has another name also, another names also. Those are a set to sentence, declarative sentence. The second one is imperative sentence. The third one is exclamatory sentence. Children, while writing, the spelling of exclamatory is important as well as imperative also. And the last one, interrogative sentence. I repeat, sentences are of four types. Number one is statement, imperative, exclamatory, and the last one is interrogative sentence. Now, let us have a glance on statement. Statement sentence is one which states or declares something. I repeat, a statement sentence is one which states or declares something. It has a structure. Usually structures are called syntax. The structure is subject plus verb plus dash 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 full stop. But some English grammar books shows you object in this place. That is why I write both of here. I repeat the structure, it's very important. Subject plus verb plus dash 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 full stop. For your better understanding, I give a small definition, easy definition to you about the statement sentence. I myself says statement sentence is nothing but answer sentence. It means if somebody asks you a question, then you can reply. All your replies usually express in statement sentence. Let us have a glance again. The statement sentence begins with subject. It is followed by verb. Lastly, full stop, sometimes object. Okay, it's very important, boys and girls. So, have in mind, keep in mind. Now, let us take some examples. Number one, you are a nice man. Let me explain this example with the help of the above structure. In the first subject place, I take the subject you. Here I wanted to talk about you. So you is the subject. It is followed by verb A-R-E-R. It is followed by dash dash dash. In the dash dash dash, a nice man. Suppose you want to write here a bad man. That's also right according to the structure. You are a nice man, you are a bad man. But the subject and verb must be in order in the statement sentence. The second example, in the subject place, I take she. In the verb's place, I take is. In the place of dash, dash, dash or object, I take an ugly girl. She is an ugly girl. Lastly, full stop. Dear students, don't forget to write, put a full stop. My name is Lena Sharma. In the third sentence, in the subject place, we take my name. Subject is also my name. Verb is. In the object place, Lena Sharma. In the fourth example, can you see what is the subject and verb? Yes, you are right. The subject is they, verb is are, playing cricket is dash 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 will stop. In the fifth example, subject is he, verb is written from in the dash 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 from America last year. Good. A statement sentence is of two types. Do you think there are two types of statement sentences? Yes, absolutely, there are two types of statements. What are they? Let us check. I show the differences, main differences between these two sentences. There, number one is affirmative statement. The second one is negative statement. Affirmative statement. We get these sentences with yes or positive sense. I repeat, we get affirmative statements with yes or positive sense. Negative statement. We get these sentences with no or negative sense. So we call these affirmative sentences as positive. We call negative statements as negative. Let us check the examples. Example number one in the affirmative statement. Yes, I am ready. For example, somebody asks you a question. Are you ready? What's your answer? How many answers are possible answers are there? There are two possible answers. One is, I am ready. It is called affirmative. If you say no, I am not ready, this is called negative statements. So statements are of two types. The second one is yes, we are going to school. In negative, no, we are not going to school. Third one, she is my sister. No, she is not my sister. These are the affirmative and negative statements. Students, second one, let us check the second one. Imperative sentence. You know, students, it is very, very, very most important. Usually, in our classroom transaction, in our day-to-day life situations, in spoken English, we frequently use imperative sentences in informal way. Okay. Let us have a sight on definition. An imperative sentence is one which expresses a command, a request, or a wish. So, from this definition, we understood imperative sentences can express commands, requests, and wishes. Important points about imperative sentence. The first one is, please keep in mind, it's very important. Imperative sentences begin with oaths. Boys, let us recollect what happened in statement sentence. The structure of the statement sentence. Statement sentence begins with subject, it's followed by verb. Do you remember? But the imperative sentence begins with the verb only. There is no subject. What will happen? No subject. Subject may be understood. The subject, you, is understood here. Generally, after commands or requests, we must write full stop. But after wishes, we must write exclamatory marks. I repeat, imperative sentences begins with verb. First point, no subject. Usually we understood you is the subject. After commands and requests, we write fully stops. But after wishes, we write exclamatory mark. Let us take some examples on orders and commands and requests and wishes. First, order and commands. Number one, stop talking. Children, I want to give here one beautiful endeavor, daily classroom transaction example. That is, if you want to get into the class, what would you do? Just you take permission from your teacher, aren't you? Yes. How can you express to take the permission? Usually students ask, teacher, may I come in? Isn't it not? Sometimes you say, teacher, may I come in? Then what the teacher's reply? Teacher says, get in or come in. Teacher says, get in or come in. But teacher doesn't address you as you come in or you get in. Simply she says or he says, get in or come in. In that expression, the subject you is understood. It means you is implied. Just say come in or get in. In the same way, stop talking. Here stop talking means you stop talking. Here stop is verb. Imperative sentence, we have already learned, imperative sentence begins with verb. So stop is verb. Don't talk, it's verb. Don't talk in the class. Post this letter. All these are called orders or commands. Second request. When we add a request word, usually it's part of species adverb. A request word, please, to the orders, they turn into requests. Let us check. Please come regularly. Please don't talk. Please close the door. Then come is verb, don't talk is verb, close is a verb. These verbs, these sentences begin with verbs, so these are called imperative sentences. When we add please to all these sentences, they become request sentences in imperative sentence. The last one is wish. May God bless you. May you live long. I want to give some more examples. Children, do you notice? Lastly, these sentences end with exclamatory marks. We have already discussed wish The sentence wish ends with an exclamatory mark. Students, do you remember one of your friends came to you and gave you a chocolate and said that the day is his birth anniversary or birthday? What would you do then? Many, many happiness of the day or happy birthday. It means I wish you many, many happy returns of the day, but you do not say I wish you, isn't it? It means you is implied in the imperative sentence. That is called wish. Wishes are expressed in imperative sentences only. Without knowing this grammar point, we usually use such kind of sentences in our daily life situations. One more very, very important part of imperative sentences. Imperative sentences also start with let, L-E-T, let. I repeat, imperative sentences also start with let. Children, do you know what is the meaning of let? Yeah, let, it has two parts of speech. One is noun, the another one is verb. The meaning of noun, let, small. We use booklet, pamphlet, etc. Playlet. Verb, let means allow. The verb conjugations of let. Here we have already discussed imperative sentences begin with verb. Let means allow. Let us take some, here is in a structure, it's also very important, please keep in mind and I take down into your notes. Check the structure. Let plus object plus v1 plus dash 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 lastly full stop. Do you know what you mean by object? The subject is of two forms, subjective form and objective form. I is subject, its object is me. V is subject, its object is us. U is subject, its object is you. He is subject, object is him. She is subject, its object is her. It is subject, its object is it. They is subject, its object is them. So I think you know all of these. I will give the detailed notes about subject and object in the later class. Now let us check these examples. Example number one. Let me sing a song. Let us check this sentence with the structure. Let, at the beginning, let. Object of I is me. Here, V1, S-I-N-G, sing, it's a verb. Let me sing a song. What is the meaning of this sentence? For example, there is an audition, there is a pro concert in your college, there is in your school, there is a school day program. You want to participate in the school day program. Then you go and ask the school leader, SPL. Then how can you express your request? That is, let me sing a song in school day program. Here that means allow me sing a song, because let means allow as verb. The second one, let them start. According to the structure, beginning let, object of the they is them, verb is start, let them start. Let you and me do this work. In the third sentence, object is you and me, both. But you know, the subject and object forms of the you are same. There is no change. That's why here you comes as you. Let you and me do this work. Here I want to tell one more thing, my dear boys and girls. That is, you and me. You and me means, sir, why don't we write me and you? Is it correct? No, it's absolutely wrong. Why? Whenever order of pronouns, there is a small grammar point, that is order of pronouns. Order of pronouns is, first you have to write the second person pronoun, it is followed by third person pronoun, if there is, lastly the first person pronoun. So first you have to write the second person pronoun always. If there is no second person pronoun, then you have to write the third person pronoun. Let you and me do this work. I think you understand. The fourth example, let us play together. Let her come in. Let Srinivas complete his work. Okay, we discuss, we have completed imperative sentence. Again, I repeat, imperative sentences begin with verb, ends with full stop. Subject you is understood. Imperative sentences are of three types: orders or commands, requests and wish. Imperative sentences also begin with let. The structure of the imperative sentence begin with let is let plus object plus V1 dash 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 full stop. Good. Next, exclamatory sentence. It is very, very useful if you want to express your feelings in English language. You must know about these exclamatory sentences. Exclamatory sentences express sudden and strong feeling. Exclamatory sentences start with exclamation words like what or how. Subject and verb are present in the end. Children, here very important point, the third one is subject and verb are present at the end. Usually a sentence begins with subject and verb, but exclamatory sentences, in the exclamatory sentence, subject and verb are present at the end. Let me explain this sentence with the help of an example. First one, how lovely it is. In this sentence, it and is present at the end. Do you notice it? It is the subject, is the verb. Generally, sentences begin with it is. Okay. But in the exclamatory, it's very important to notice this point. How is an exclamatory word? Lovely it is. Okay. Lastly, it's end with exclamatory mark. How fast time flies away. What a beautiful sight it is. What a fool you are. What a tragic end. Children, just notice the fifth sentence. What a tragic end. But where is the subject and verb? Here, in the some sentences in exclamatory, in our day-to-day life situation, we imply the subject and verb. Actually, the sentence, the fifth sentence is, what a tragic end it is. But here, it is implied. In the sixth sentence also, what a terrible accident it is. What a terrible accident it is. But it is implied. I think you understand what is an exclamatory sentence. Class. The next one is, change an exclamatory sentence into a statement. Check here, what a beautiful flower it is. It is an exclamatory sentence. Okay, how can we change the sentence into statement? As you all know, usually the subject it and is present at the end of the sentence in the exclamatory sentence. But in the statement sentence, the subject and the verb present at the beginning of the sentence. Okay, do you notice this? This is statement, this is exclamatory. And the another change, difference is, exclamatory sentences end with exclamation mark, whereas the statement sentence end with a full stop. Of course, here no full stop, but don't worry, you have to keep a full stop here. What a beautiful flower it is. I take this pot it is, and the paste here it is. And we have to change this red word what into very. What and how, look all these sentences. What and how are converted into very in the statement sentences. So, it is indefinite article a or am are both same in exclamatory and statements. Look here. It is a very. What is converted into very? The rest is the same. Beautiful flower. Beautiful flower. Lastly, full stop. Have to write. What a nice man you are. Just check. You are is, you is the subject or is the verb presented then in the end of the sentence. But I take these two at the beginning. You are a very nice man. Very comes from what? Next, the third one, how lovely it is. Usually, it is the subject and verb. When the sentence begins with the subject and verb, it is. How convert turns into very. Lastly, we take the adverb lovely. It is very lovely. The third one, what a terrible accident. It is a very terrible accident. How bad it is. It is very bad. How clever you are. You are very clever. Okay. Next, interrogative. The last one is interrogative sentence. An interrogative sentence is one which asks a question. I repeat, an interrogative sentence is one which ask a question. Look here. Question. 9 question words are there. Number 1 is what, where, when, why, which, who, whose, whom, how. I think all of you know about these 9 question words. Next. There are 24 helping verbs. Those also known as auxiliary verbs. For making a question an interrogative sentence, we required question words as well as helping verbs. Those helping verbs are am, is, are, was, were, do, does, did, of course, does, did, do, did, has, have, had, shall, should, will, would, can, could, may, might, day, need, use it to, ought to, and must. I repeat these 24 helping verbs. The first part, am, is, are, was, were, do, does, did, have, has, had, shall, should, will, would, can, could, may, might, dare, need, use it to, ought to, and must. Okay. Next. Question is of two types. Let us check those questions. The first one is direct question. The second one is indirect question. Direct question. It has a structure, that is question word. We have already discussed in the above slide. The second one is helping verbs. Question words are 9. Helping verbs are 24. Just now we discussed. Plus subject plus verb. We have already known about these two. Lastly, question mark. Repeat. Question word, helping verb, subject plus verb plus dash 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 question mark. I give here a few examples. Number one, where are you going? Just check with the structure. Question word, where, helping verb, are you, are, and subject, you, and verb, going. Sometimes, in some sentences, we do not have main verbs. Don't bother about with such questions. Why are you so dull? Who are you? In this sentence, there is no main verb. Just check with the structure. First question word who, helping verb are, and subject is you. It's finished. Fourth one, why can't you come? Why does he come late every day? I think you understand the direct question. Now, indirect question. It is somewhat different from the direct question, but children, it's very, very, very most important. In my experience of 23 years of teaching, I noticed many people, of teachers, students, make mistakes while using indirect questions. Let's check the structure. Dash, dash, dash. What is this dash, dash, dash? Students, we have to supply some information in this area. It is followed by question words plus subject plus verb plus dash, 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 please stop. Dear students, here a very important thing is you have to notice the difference between the direct question and indirect question. Once we go back, the direct question, question word is followed by helping verb. Helping verb is nothing but verb. Question word is followed by verb plus subject. But in the indirect question, question word is followed by subject plus verb. One more important thing, in the direct question, direct question begins with question word, but indirect question begins with a phrase or a sentence. And in the middle of the sentence, there is a question word. It is followed by statement structure. Students, do you remember what is the statement structure? Subject plus verb is the statement structure. And one more striking difference is the direct question ends with question mark, whereas the indirect question ends with full stop. These are the very, very important points we have to notice. Just check. Tell me where you are going. Usually our question is, where are you going? But in that question, tell me where you are going. Children, how can you say it is indirect question? Can you say, can you support it is indirect question or direct question? Yes, you are right. We can find in that question, the question word present in the middle of the sentence. And it is followed by subject you and followed by verb, lastly full stop. And question word is preceded by a sentence, tell me, supplied by, it is supplied. Tell me is supplied. Tell me where you are going. Second one. Please tell me when you can do this work. Let us check with the structure. Dash, dash, dash. In the dash, 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 here, please tell me. Plus, question word, when, next subject, you, next verb, can do, next dash, 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 this verb, plus, please stop. Let us go through all these examples. I know what your name is. Usually, we ask, what is your name? But in indirect question, we say the sentence, I know what your name is. You must, the fourth one is, you must tell me where you went last night. Lastly, please stop. Tell me what your name is. the king asked the soldier why he was wondering about the world. The father asked his son why he had broken the mirror. The teacher asked the boy whether he had been absent the previous day. Mohan asked Prasad if he would give him a rupee. This is indirect question. Difference between direct and indirect questions. Just have a glance overall. Question word, helping verb, subject, verb, lastly question mark is direct question. Dash dash dash, question word, subject plus verb plus dash dash dash, full stop. With examples, where does she go overnight? Tell me where she goes overnight. Here, does plus go becomes as goes in indirect sentence. Where is the post office? Please tell me where the post office is. The difference is question mark, full stop, subject, verb subject, subject and verb. How you complete your work? You must tell me you have completed your work. I think you understand the difference between direct question and indirect question. Dear students, here I give you some exercise. Please do it carefully after going through the notes one or two times and try to attempt to write the answers. After completion of all your answers, then check the answers given below under here. Here, these are the examples. They are going to college. You are reading a book. You have to do it. Change the following statement sentences into question. They are going to college. You are reading a book. They will come tomorrow. You can do this work. She has gone away. He works hard. She speaks good English. They write novels. She speaks. Here a small mistake. She speaks good English, they write novels, they play tennis, they come regularly. And here I gave a small formulas. Three is very important while changing a statement sentence into question. That is, do is equal to do plus do, does is equal to does plus do, did is equal to did plus do. With the help of these helping verbs, you can convert all these 20 statement sentences into questions. Followed by these, you will be given some more exercises, homework. You must complete all, try to do all these works and check your answers later. Have a nice day. Thank you one and all.